And Forest's miserable night is complete now. Their captain Pierce sent off, down to 10 men. There's the final whistle. They've lost 3-1. What a lucky ground this is for Tottenham. For the fourth successive season and the sixth time in the last eight seasons, Tottenham have beaten Nottingham Forest at the City Ground. Lineker, Jury and Bergson getting the goals to cancel out the early strike by Clough, deflected in by Stewart. Clough, the manager, a very unhappy man, and the game ended on a controversial note for Forest, with Pierce dismissed in the last few seconds. The final score, Nottingham Forest 1, Tottenham Hotspur 3.
Brian, Stuart Pearce was sent off for foul and abusive language. What are your comments about that?
There's no excuse at all. As an England player and as captain of this club, it was ironic that we just received an award before the match for the best behaved club in the country. No excuse whatsoever.
Now, it's the same referee that sent Paul Gascoigne off for the same thing on New Year's Day.
I wish it had been the referee in the cup final then.
What are you going to do about Stuart? Because he's your captain. I mean, you always take action when these things happen.
He used a word which wasn't acceptable to the referee. It's very, very difficult sometimes because you say, you know, certain things. It wasn't directed at the referee, and I would have thought in the 89th minute, with a player down on the floor, tackled from behind, I'd have thought the referee might have had his mind on other matters.
That's interesting. I mean, we're all assuming it was at the referee. Who was it aimed at one of your players?
Well, I'm not sure.
Right, but it was aimed at the referee.
He did swear, Stuart Pearce.
But not at the referee, as far
as you know. I don't think so.
No. It was stupid to do it in the last minute, wasn't it? Stupid to do it anyway, but with a few seconds to go.
Well, there's no excuse for it. It's as simple as that. I don't take it on board to criticise referees. I never have and I never will. What they do, they do. What they do, we accept, and we take the consequences. And I didn't think, Gary, excuse me, I thought you were going to butt in then.
No, I was just taking a breath
lovely.
Of air.
Thank you.
I was going to butt in,
I didn't think we could have, or we should have lost 3-1. I think we played better than the score suggests.
Indeed, they played so well on Saturday against Notts County, didn't they? Well, coming up next, we have the further thoughts of the Forest manager, Brian Clough, on the challenges of the new seasons. It's an exclusive interview with Central Sports Specials' Jimmy Greaves. That plus more top football action after the break.
Just look at all that ground in grime.
Can't see anything shifting that.
Don't tell me. These stubborn stains are impossible.
Sorry, love.
This grease, it hasn't budged.
It just never gets deep down clean, does it?
Typical. They've never heard of Shell Advanced petrol.
Yeah. It's got special detergents that actually clean your engine while you're driving.
Exactly. And if you use it regular, it can improve your car's performance.
You think they'd know that?
Of course you would.
Right, see you next week, lads.
Do you know where this goes?
Shell Advanced Petrol cleans your engine as you drive.
I don't think this is going to work.
You may be right.
We don't seem to have much in common.
I know. I hate opera, you hate jazz.
And I loathe modern art.
It's my job.
So, about the only thing we do have in common is...
our taste in coffee.
Golden roasted, richer, smoother, Nescafe Gold Blend.
Hello.
I want to see you. Now. Next week. Thanks very much.
Bye.
I think you're next, sir.
Yeah.
What's it to be then?
Just a trim, please.
You could have a Lionel Blair cut, like mine.
Lionel Blair doesn't have his hair cut like yours.
That's if he comes here.
Time for a sharp exit. Time for a cool, sharp harp.
Pint of harp, please, Chief.
Welcome back to Central Sports Special. We've seen Brian Clough's team in action. Now the maestro's ready for another match. Jimmy Greaves went to the Forest Ground early this week for this exclusive interview.
I set my stall out to try and win the league because I think it's going to be that tight. Any one of six or seven sides could win it. It'll depend on injuries. It's an old manager's cliche, but it's perfectly true. But the top managers have strengthened the squads to such an extent that we're in progress of having, I would say, the best season for 10, 15 years.
Do you fancy your chances then?
Well, I'm not saying we. I'm saying the Football League in that respect. Yes, because apart from George at Arsenal, we've all signed good players, we think. And it's an exciting time in football. The gates are good, the players are good, the managers are hanging on by their fingernails, just like I am, and so on and so on and so on.
You say you signed good players, but there's been a lot of money spent this year, Brian.
There has, I know, but there's only been money spent, I assume, that's in the game. Because I couldn't spend threepence unless I had it. I bought a young lad, a second division player, and I valued your comments talking about him, actually. Because it's good. Opinion makes the world go round. And certainly football.
This is Carl Tyler.
Yes.
You think he's a good prospect?
Gates are good, the players are good, the managers are hanging on by their fingernails, just like I am.